Okay, today we're going to talk about spider guard and about the basic scissor sweep from a spider guard. Spider guard is one of my most favorite sweeps, one of my most favorite guards. I always prefer to play close distance, but then again, I think it's important to explain and to use it. Look, the main detail I'm going to talk about today is about the head motion. Look, so what I often see happening is this. If look, I talked to the studio, I had like one video already about how hip movement and head movement you can use to stay on top. I will put a link at the end of the video on top so you can see that as well. But look at this, look, Dino, lay on your back, please. Okay, look. So look at this. Dino is laying flat on his back, and I'll turn to your stomach. Okay, good. Very easy, right? Go back. Now, what I often see people doing is that they leave their head behind when they get on top. So look, imagine this. Imagine Dino's head stays here, and you're gonna rotate to your belly, Dino. Just rotate to your belly, see? It's impossible for him to rotate if I stop his head. Now, what you see a lot of times happening is this. People try to sweep, no, okay. So I try to sweep someone, I get over here, and I keep my head behind. Even if I would get completely on top, all I gotta do is push my head back, and you fall. You know, every time when I commit to do a sweep, or try to get on top, I try to recover from a sweep, I always imagine like a cat. If you see a cat fall from the tree, she'll always go first with the head, then the shoulders, then the knees, then the toes, and the hip. It just follows. So, first of this, look, if I'm here, this is the main detail. Like, can I come here with you on this side? Yeah. So if I try to do the scissor sweep, you walk a bit over here, look, and I'm stretching my legs, and I'm looking away. I really limit myself to the, well, as far as I can go. So it really works here if I look away, see? So my head is already, the first thing I have to do is actually bring my head on top. Alright, see, my head is already on top. It's like looking to the floor. And now from here, if I keep a stretch, I can take my shoulders away, and it will bring Dino with me. Now, will this sweep work, yes or no? That really depends on timing, where he's waiting on that moment. If he keeps his weight completely on the other side, it will not work. So you have to build like a little bit of a trap. So, the first thing I always do in every position, when I learn something new, I don't right away try to go for the sweep or for the attack itself. The first thing I always want is to be able to stay in a position forever. So and then when I can stay there forever, see, I'm gonna see how he can move and how I can negate his motion, stay in that position forever. Now after a while, see, if I feel, okay, I can stay here and I can get aware of his motions, and the second step is, how can I use his motions to my advantage? Once I know how to use his motions to my advantage, know, feel the timing of the attack, then the third phase is, Dino's just gonna be tight, see, and I'm gonna have to try to make him do what I want to do, to set up the attack. And the fourth level would be, imagine I'm behind, so I can imagine I'm first leading on points and Dino has to move, and then I can use that. The next level is, I'm gonna imagine I'm behind on points, and that's the hardest actually, imagining I'm behind on points and Dino just stalling, that's like the hardest. And the more realistic level for training in the end would be to say, okay man, let's fight and 0-0, and let's, you try to pass and I try to sweep, and you try not to. Well, you have to imagine the referee also. So we do different things. In the beginning, you imagine you're leading on points or self-defense, help is gonna come, and later you imagine you're behind on points or equal on points. Now, so it's like a half spider guard sweep with the motion. First of all, the grips. When I take the spider guard grips, I always prefer to put my thumb on the inside of it. So if I go here like this, you can just go over, see, and re-grip, and it will cancel my grip. So I want to be here, see? And I want actually to push the gi down a little bit. So using this kind of a grip to catch inside the sleeve and bring my wrists down. Now go back, please. I don't have a spider guard yet. Come close, please, you know? Yeah. Jiu-jitsu for me is always, not keep your knees on the floor and keep your shoulders low, yeah. Jiu-jitsu for me is always give the opponent what he wants until he does not want it anymore. So if I want to try to get my foot here on Dino's elbows, you keep tired, you know? See, I'm gonna really have to work hard. Right now, I have my both feet on his hips. He tried to go forward, Dino. There's no way he can pass my guard. But if I start to move and really am eager to do that, that's actually when he's going to get a grip and he's going to be able to pass. So in the beginning, I'm happy with what I have. I'm going to stay forever. So I'm going to catch, put my feet on his hips. And now, very important, I make the rock bottom. So what does this mean, look? I'm going to put my chin up, arch my back, elbows on the floor. Push forward, please, Dino. He can do this forever. He's not going to be able to pass my guard. Now, if he's very eager, keep going, please. Start standing up. See if he goes up. Oh, keep going up, forward. I can actually start lifting him here. It's a very good exercise. a very good way to sweep if he's like really overcommitting and being eager. Now, when are we gonna use the spider guard? Look, it's like this. Go with me to the center, please. So walk to the center. Parallel, yeah, in the center. Turn a bit, yeah, freeze. Great. So in the beginning, he's gonna put forward pressure. Okay, good. So now from here, he feels does not work. So he's gonna put his hip on the floor, so his butt on the heels, and I'll start stretch, put pressure on his hip. Push your hip forward and shoulders backwards. Push your hip up. Yeah. That's what he's gonna try to do. Once he gets here, he can connect to my pants, and then he can start passing his guard. So you have to react before that. So what I'm gonna do here, look, I'm gonna try to keep this here. See, if he tries to go up, see, I'm actually gonna follow with my hip and keep walking closer. See, at this point, if he's here, so try to stand up, please, Dino. It's gonna be very hard for him to do so without leaning forward again. So you can actually cancel him in this area already. Come back, please, in the center. Now, what else can Dino do? We can start rotating around. Walk around, please. And in this case, see, I could follow Gubor of a sideway guard or keep parallel and keep following. Now, go back to the center, please. Now, if you keep canceling out from here, look, you know, try to pull your both arms out at the same time, please. That's hard, right? So, if you keep canceling them out like this, and competition, you have the advantage that usually the pressure pass from top is only going to get stalling. So, if I just move my butt around here a bit and act like I'm moving, the referee, like, it's a pity, like, the rules are like that, but referees are most likely give the guy on top the penalty. So, you can actually can bite your time here. Now, what am I going to wait for? Look, it's easy for Dino to pull one arm through the same at one time. So, I'm here, he's going to pull, he's going to push it, like, push your hip forward a bit, please. Yeah, push your hip forward, go up, see, and try to pull this arm free. When he pulls, that's what I'm going to fill the space with my elbow. Now, stay in the center, please, for a second. In the center, yeah. What am I going to do? Look, after imagine this, once we're in this position, every time when we do jiu-jitsu, it's always better. He can do two things with his elbow. An elbow is generally stronger if the elbow is close to the hip, so the arm is stronger close to the hip, and it gets weaker the further it gets away from the hip. Now, if he gets all the way up, see, and I start pushing his elbow, that's where he's actually going to get out of balance. That's what we need to do the technique of today. So, right away, understand, if the elbow is close, it's strong, the more it goes away, it's weaker. So, what I'm going to do in the beginning, when I'm doing my... So, he starts to push his hip up, see? Yeah, I pull his arm back. That's when I'm going to put the space. Now, stay in the middle for a second, just to explain. So, imagine I still have a central guard. The thing I always said, like, from the center, it's very hard to sweep, but it's easy to defend. So stay in the middle, please, yeah, here. What am I gonna do now? Look, if I start to open my knee, look at the arm is here. If I open my knee, it's easy for Dino to close your elbow, see? And I cannot work anymore. At this point, he can start to swivel his hand inside or outside, and it's hard. So what I'm gonna do in the beginning is stay exactly in the middle, please, for the camera, yeah. I'm gonna close my knees and open my feet. See, I tried to close your heel and elbow now, please. It's way harder, right? This is a few things. Look, if I'm here, if Dino starts to walk around on this side, walk around, please. Keep walking. See? I can actually just follow around. Go back to the other side. Just go back to the center. See, you need to show from here. Sit down. Yeah. So what I'm gonna do? Usually when I'm playing here, there's like a whole bunch of options you have. And let's say my favorite attack here is to do the scissor sweep from there. So I have all kinds of virtual attacks which I don't really commit to, and I'm gonna really wait until he overcommits to the technique that I want to do actually. So I'm going to keep my knees close and open my foot away. See, right away putting pressure on his elbow. He walks this way, I stop him. See, if he comes forward, see, I can actually bend. Go forward, please. Start stretching my elbow as well. See, and bring his elbow up. So outside he's going to go down again. See, and what I'm waiting for now is that he's going to start circling to this side. When he starts circling, see, he actually leaves his elbow behind. Start circling, please, Dino. Freeze. As he comes here, he's going to bring the arm higher. See, rotate with him, so keep my knee inside, my foot outside. As he walks, see, I'm gonna rotate my shoulder in, see, and then bring my hip out. Now, what usually people do at this point, see, don't move, okay? When the hip, don't just stay, do not move, please, thank you. So, what I usually do is just make a disconnected hip escape. See, if I just hip escape here, there is no connection. I have to use my hip escape to make pressure. Hip escape is not making distance with the hip. Hip escape, the point of hip escape is to transfer pressure from your hips to your shoulders and vice versa. So when I'm here, I'm actually going to rotate with my top shoulder first. See, putting tension on the arm. And as I rotate completely in, that's when I'm going to rotate my butt away. See, and I really rotate his elbow up. At this point, see, when his arm is open, that's when I'm going to stretch my leg out. See, I'm going to come on top of my elbow. And at this point, it really depends on where his weight is. If his weight is over his hip, like outside of his knee, stay here please. That's when I can bring my foot out, see, and can do the sweep. Now, the sweep is just kicking and moving away with your body. Go back please, yeah. So what I prefer in the beginning to do beginners, stay outside of the weight please, yeah. Stay here, don't catch with your elbow, yeah. I try to do this motion first. Bend, kick one, two, three, put tension, move, don't fall. Move your shoulders away, look away, see, and bring it with you. Once we get here, if I just try to get up straight away, you know, roll in please. It's a race and he's gonna get up just where we were. Go back please. It's a race we can't win. Come closer, here. So what I'm gonna do here, look, if I look away, put my head to the floor, so try to get up now, Dino. Harder, right? You can definitely get up still. But at this point, it's a race that I can win. Look, if I start to go up right away, bringing my hip up, then again, it's gonna be faster. Go back. Down, yeah. So what I'm doing here, so go up please, Dino, go. Put my head on the floor, start windshield wiping. Even if he comes up, I can bring his hands down, start fighting from turtle, which would, if I get to his back, technically count already as a sweep. Or if I'm a bit faster, so one, two, three, kick, bring him away, and go up right away as we go. Now try to get up, Dino, at this point, see? Now I can start coming in, or even if he keeps pushing, see? Circle the leg out, rotate, see? And go to his back. So once again, please. We're gonna go again from this angle. Go to the center. So again, keep your knees closed. Make X legs. He's usually moving around. He makes distance. Try to pull your arm out. One arm, post on the elbow. Knee inside, foot outside. He circles to my preferred side. See, freeze, Dino. See, as he goes, I rotate in. See? When my shoulder is past the center line, my head is going to the floor. See, that's when I'm gonna bring my hip out as far out as possible. And always making sure the shoulder stays turned. And from here I can't sweep, to roll the shoulder in at all times. Now I'm gonna stretch my top leg, see here. And now it depends entirely on his weight. If his weight is on the outside, see, I keep pushing, open my elbow, get up, put the foot on the floor. As I practice, one, two, three, kick and drag. Go back, please. So, and later it goes in one motion. Now, the advantage of this is, look, it's not guaranteed that Dino is gonna fall. So this is my first attack. So let's say it brings yourself more to the center. Yeah, freeze, please. See? From here, I could let go of the sleeve and go to the collar, which Dino actually this week filmed a very nice set of loop chokes. So once he puts it on, so upload that one first, and I will connect it to the video. You can see that one as well. So very good.
Sweep as well.
Yeah, scissor sweep. Yeah, good. So here is a collar choke, so the collar sleeve, which is a very great guard as well. And if he's more extreme in his motion, so he can go one. See, if he really pushes back against his arms and go down, see, I can catch the collar, go underneath, and start attacking, do a plata. So one more time, just the basic scissor sweep. Go here, please. Let's do it now faster a bit. We're here, pull the arm back, put the arm, see, go, circle. Easy again there. Go. Here. So now I will start from here, which is also possible, of course. He walks, rotate the shoulder, not the way, put the foot. Kick and drag. One less detail, go back up please, go here. If he puts his knee on the floor, if he opens his knee too far, and if I cannot reach over, I'm just gonna block here, do the exact same thing. If he puts his foot on top, put your foot on the floor, yeah, I can also stop here. Now very important is not to sweep towards the, so we have 12, 6, 3, 9. It's very important not to sweep to the 3, 6, 9 and 12, because we can always post hand and feet on that side. It's important to go in between. So I actually sweep to like 1.5 o'clock in this case. So 12 o'clock, 3 o'clock, 1.5 is right in the middle. So even then, if he puts his leg up, I can kick, he'll go away, see, I'm dragging forward, and go on top. So thank you, Dino. Don't forget right now to check Dino's video as well about the loop choke. And on the channel also find up the video about the scissor sweep. Thanks a lot.